focused. Education matters. This early on a Sunday, it's only a week before government schools are set to reopen, but the Basic Education Portfolio Committee says the province of the Eastern Cape is simply not ready to start the academic year. Let's discuss some of these concerns and how quickly we can fix them. Committee Chair Bongiwe Mbinqo-Gigaba joining us this morning. Bongiwe, good morning to you. I'm taking a look at some of the articles over the past few days, concerns about scholar transport, the number of textbooks being delivered as well, but also the curriculums for the year being discussed as well. It doesn't look like a good start to the academic year in the Eastern Cape. What's happening?
Morning to you and morning to the viewers at home as well. Look, let me correct the issue of scholar transport. Scholar transport actually in the Eastern Cape is doing very well. We must commend that. The delivery of textbooks, it's our main concern. You know, it's about 28% in some districts and about 32% the delivery of textbooks, in particular in schools. And you would remember, schools, if we did not have COVID, were supposed to have been reopened already. Now, the schools were shifted by 2 weeks. And now you are left only with 1 week, and the province is at less than 50% in terms of delivering textbooks and stationery in most of the schools in the province.
Why do you think that is? I'm seeing reports from Sowetan Live saying that they're reporting only 20.7% of schools have not concluded their delivery of workbooks. Why do you think there's been this delay, Bongiwe?
I cannot say precisely why is this delay, and I think more it could be management issues, because the schools that we have visited, you would find that we are told no. In most of the reports, the school was reporting delivery of textbook none, but when we are there in the morning, you are told that no, then the delivery came in this morning. So which means then that there is a problem with managing that process, because you would not have a principal compiling a report 5 days before saying there is none, and then in the morning suddenly, because you are in the school, then you would be told that no, they received the books in the morning. So they made sure that when you arrived, there is textbooks that are waiting for you in the school.
Bongiwe, let's talk a little bit about the teacher vacancies as well. I see that you're quoted in a number of online articles talking about the number of vacancies from both a teacher and school management position. Just tell me how bad that situation is. And before I say goodbye to you as well now, how are we going to get on top of this? We're just days away from the start of the academic year. What do you think you can get done?
The two districts that we visited, in Joburg and I'm not sure, I think it's Chrisani West or something, they have promised that they will fill the vacancies. There is a number of vacancies, particularly of teachers, that needs to be filled. And again, it's the worry that you have raised. If you are saying they will be filled before you open the schools, which is actually a week from now, and you haven't, there is no process towards that. So, which means it's not realistic. It's not going to happen. But it is the reality. There are a lot of vacancies, and most are caused by the fact that teachers had died because of COVID, but others had just resigned because of age issues. But you need to get those teachers. The issue of learners in the Eastern Cape in particular, I think we must applaud them. They have placed learners and they don't have issues of learner transport, I think they are managing the issue of radius. It's just those and those schools that they need to manage more, but they are managing the issue of learner transport very well, to an extent that there is no school that has really complained of not being able to get learners to school. So they have placed learners very well.
The issue of the teachers, which we're so short of at the moment, I'm sure we're going to follow up as well as we hear that they are going to be placing as many teachers as possible. Only a week to do it, though. But I appreciate your time in speaking to us this morning. Bongiwe Mbinqo-Gigaba from the Basic Education Portfolio Committee. Just before I...